as pro-Trump supporters stormed the U.S. Capitol Wednesday by knocking down barriers, smashing windows, and ransacking congressional offices, Black Lives Matter activists wondered why law enforcement showed so much restraint compared to the heavy-handed tactics that officers used on them.
Demonstrators in Portland have been tear gassed, beaten by both local and federal troops. And so there's definitely a double standard. And I don't think had that been a mob of black individuals that it would have played out the same way.
Specifically, activist Greg McKelvey points to the dozens of people who were roughed up and tear gassed by federal officers as they demonstrated for racial justice outside the federal courthouse in downtown Portland this summer.
I was one of the individuals that was tear gassed for simply being in that park.
This disparity between the police response to Black Lives Matter protests nationwide and the violence in Washington, D.C. was not lost on President-elect Joe Biden.
No one can tell me that if it had been a group of Black Lives Matter protesting yesterday, they wouldn't have been treated very, very differently.
Those people were protected. Their actions were protected, their safety.
Teresa Rayford, founder of Don't Shoot Portland, said images like these help solidify a long-held suspicion that conservative white protesters don't have to play by the same rules.
I mean, like, come on, what kind of savagery would be said about people like myself if we even went in there and wrote on a wall?
Rayford said the lack of police response to this violent mob shows a racial double standard.
You've seen here in Portland where we might have an event scheduled for 11 o'clock, but there's riot cops there at 10:30.
Black Lives Matter protesters and civic leaders not only denounced police for taking little action, but also President Trump, whose rhetoric they say helped fuel the violence. Kyle Eboshi, KGW News.